Welcome, friends. Thank you all for being here. The great message of the Hibakusha, the people who survived the bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, is that this should never, ever happen again to another human being. They pray, and they speak out, and they continue to speak, those who are still alive, that no human being should ever suffer again the way they did in Hiroshima and Nagasaki 72 years ago. So here we are, commemorating and bringing forward their message so that other people will hear and dedicate themselves to never having again a reason for ever using such terrible weapons. And we happen to live at a moment where there's a ray of hope. There is now a nuclear weapons peace treaty in the world. On July 2nd of this year, 7th of this year, 122 nations within the United Nations voted for a nuclear weapons ban treaty. The signing of the document will begin on September 20th when 50 nations ratify the treaty. It will become international law. As you might expect, the nine nations that presently possess nuclear weapons, including our own, the United States, the only nation to ever use the weapon, have refused to join the negotiations. And after the passage of the treaty, the nations of France, Great Britain, and the United States made it exceedingly clear that they have no intention to join this treaty. That presents us with a great challenge. For the first time, the human race can point to a treaty agreed upon by 122 nations of the world that would abolish nuclear weapons. There is such a thing as international tradition that even nations who do not sign treaties, like the landmine treaty that the United States of America has refused to sign, becomes so powerful. The moral statement becomes so powerful in the world that nations that, even though they do not sign the treaty, begin to obey it. This gives us great reason for hope. It's going to be a long haul. None of us standing here today will see the end of it, but we can begin today to dedicate ourselves to getting all the nations of the world to accept this treaty to abolish nuclear weapons. So we invite you, the Buddhist Peace Fellowship, who organized this evening, invites each of us to speak from our heart, a poem, some thoughts, some feelings, a song, anything that you bring here to share with us to help us strengthen our resolve to abolish nuclear weapons.
Deterrence. It's not just deterrence. That doesn't do it. So let's hope that this treaty will take people beyond that. That's so far what the best people have come up with, and it's not good enough. So I'm grateful that the countries in the UN that voted for this were courageous.
Cities like that, besides Hiroshima and Nagasaki, not only in Japan, but all over the country and all over the world. We want to remember all those people who suffered, but people who acted on that are also suffering, I think. So only bringing the peaceful thinking towards the world will bring the real peace, I believe. So this kind of self-help is the most important thing. So thank you so much.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with each of us.
I always like the beginning of the peace walk when Mary or someone else talks about how we walk and how in every step we take, there's an opportunity to meet peace and to bring peace.
And I'm really grateful for the chance to experience the walking through town and what felt like this wild journey of trying to cultivate peace and then being like, I don't really know how to cultivate peace, and then surrendering to peace and feeling waves of grief and the whole experience of it. And for me, music is often a prayer, is a way of generating peace and offering peace.
Come lay down my sword and shield down by the riverside.
Nuclear weapons, because just thinking about them in and of itself is just disturbing to me. I think a lot of the reason for having weapons is out of fear and wanting to protect, but I think that it takes a lot of courage for peace, and so I want to do my part to advocate and to have the courage myself and try to spread the courage to others. I think, yeah, it takes a lot of courage, but I hope that by doing our part, we can convince others to be brave and to agree to let go of these kind of insane weapons. I mean, all weapons are horrible and damaging, but I can't see any downside to people agreeing to get rid of them.
Donna Nobis Pacem. Donna Nobis Pacem.
On the anniversary of the day of the atomic bombing of Hiroshima is also approximately the time of the year in Japan of the Obon ceremony. And this is a time where the spirits of the family members are invited back for feasting and for parties and for dancing. And at the end of the Bon festival, then they have lanterns that they set into the river to send the spirits back to where they came from. So this evening, in a sense, we've invited those who suffered at Hiroshima and at war everywhere to come back and to teach us this evening, to teach us, remind us, encourage us not to needlessly cause suffering and destruction of life. So as we launch the candle boats into the river, you may want to think about what your highest intention is and what you would want to launch into the world. How to encourage peace in the world, how to cultivate that ground of peace within. So, and to support this peaceful and prayerful spirit, we'll have an ongoing chant as we go down to the river and as we launch the boats into the water. And on the way down, I believe Neville will be there to hand out the boats. So this is a simple chant that's in the Japanese Buddhist tradition, and it's frequently used in peace walks and in support of nuclear disarmament. And the words to the chant are Naam Myo Renge Kyo. And the literal meaning of that is hail to the lotus. But we can think of that as what the lotus is trying to teach us, the lotus that grows in the mud, this beautiful flowering. And may we be like that kind of flowering that comes up out of the difficulties and the suffering of this world. So we'll do it like a call response. Naam Myo Renge Kyo.
Ah.